Hey, John.
Hey, Mr. Akers. Got some important information for you. Looks like Mr. Gray is the one behind all this madness.
I'll take care of it. So that's where that chump lives. Cause you're hot, then you're cold. You're yes, then you're no. You're in, then you're out. I'm changing this crap. So get up. Let's start a riot. Riot, let's start a riot. Let's start a riot. Riot, let's start a riot. Where's the peanut butter?
We don't have any peanut butter.
What do you mean? You have to be kidding me, right?
No, we sold the rest of it this morning.
Oh my gosh. Fine, I'll go find it. Get out of my way. So that's where that chump lives. This shouldn't be long, but I just felt we needed to meet face to face about this.
Oh, Chester, looking good after the accident.
Thanks, Mr. Grady. That's not what I came here to talk about. The boys down at the factory tell me we sent out some shipments of tainted peanut butter. Now, usually I would think this is just some kind of joke around the workers, but John told me this was true. And I figure if he's going to share this with me, the management, then it's legit. Do you know anything about this?
I wasn't aware, no.
That's it? You were not aware? Well, I already tried to get a couple of shipments, but I didn't get very far.
Mr. Akers, as much as I respect the enthusiasm, I think it would be better if you and your employees forgot about this. I will take care of it.
What are you going to do? I already checked with the head of our distribution department, and he says you gave a specific instruction to keep the trucks moving. Can you explain that?
Mr. Akers, perhaps he was thinking of someone else. Perhaps he had a long night and was partly intoxicated. I don't know, and neither do you. Now let me remind you, I own that factory, and you and every little employee in that building. Don't threaten me with your conspiracy theory.
Why do you want these shipments to reach the shelves? What's in it for you? I know about the charges against you. Oh, say about 10 years ago.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Don't act stupid with me. Turns out public records can be good sources of information. Read one that said you were in big with the mob. Of course, the charges were dropped before it reached trial, like every mob case. Still, it's not hard to imagine that you would leave the line of business altogether. So tell me, what's going on here?
You've done your homework. Unfortunately, you are still too dumb to see the city for what it really is. This isn't preschool anymore, kid, so grow up. In this town, everyone has connections. Even the cops are in with them. Which is why you will face a lot of resistance should you choose to continue your little mission. That peanut butter will reach store shelves by the end of this week. You know why? Because when all the stupid civilians come flocking into the grocery store, they will see our product on that shelf and pay their cash for it, and that cash will go through me, and those sick people will go through the hospital. Then the medical bills come in, and when they dish out their money for those, who do you think gets it? The cop. It's all state-run business. When the hospital is overcharged for treatment, part of that goes to the police, who in turn share the wealth with the mob in order to maintain peace in this rat's nest of a city. Meanwhile, I am making record cash here, and I'm sending some of it to my cousins in the mob. That's what business partners do. This is all business, and you better get used to
it. What? Hundreds of people sick? For a quick buck? No. No, that's not right. I'm not gonna let you do this. You're lucky I don't.
What? Report me to the police? You must not be listening, because they are in on it too. We are a triumvirate, if you will. There's us, the mob, and the police. We run this place. We can essentially control the food department. The police are supposed to be protection for this place, and they have a lot of citizens believing that they are innocent and fight for them and all that crap. Right there are two very important powers, food and security. And the mob, heck, they control everything. They are pulling the strings. Now be a good puppet and shut your mouth before we shut it for you. I've gotten my hands dirty already, and not I, the mob, or the police are afraid to do so again.
So you think what you're doing is good?
Good? There is no good, just as there is no evil. There is just profit. Take a look at our sales charts. They're through the roof this month. And now, as people continue to buy our product, the tainted shipments will find their way into sandwiches, onto crackers, and desserts. I know you have seen the success of our peanut butter. You get the monthly charts, correct?
I do. And I look at them. This is crazy. And I'm not just gonna stand here and watch.
Well, you don't sound as impressed as with the numbers as I am. So be it. It is a shame that you must contemplate things like this. But just in case, maybe you should think about a success to come. My boys predict over double the profit we usually make thanks to this stunt. Unfortunately, you will not be able to reap the benefits. But I am sure that when you see my success, our success, you will be, shall I say, blown away. Shouldn't have messed with me.
Yeah, I get it, you're an outcast. Always under attack, always coming in last. Bring it up the past, no one owes you anything, I think. You need a shotgun blast, a kick in the ass, so paranoid.
Hulk 2
Production.